Hey folks, Brian here, and I'm going to do another project video. So I bought this truck topper for $300 for my 2017 Nissan Frontier. And unfortunately, I still need to carry ladders, so I can't put the ladder rack on here that I'm used to using. I talked to the ARE dealer, they wanted $500 for a ladder rack. And I was like, you know, that's kind of expensive, buddies. So I bought this $100 ladder rack off Amazon. Made out of aluminum, it's cheap. Everybody says it's cheap. So, no surprises there. But this video is about how to install it and how I install it, because the instructions, which are right here, suck ass. And they're in Chinglish, half Chinese, half English. So anyway, let's get it on. I think this will hold this. I'm using my 360 camera today because it's going to give you guys a better view. So this is a universal ladder rack. And universal is a nice way of saying fits everything with a lot of adjustment. Fits nothing without adjustment. So the first thing that the instructions say is to do a rough assembly. And see how it fits. So here's that rough assembly, and we're going to set it here in the middle, kind of, sort of. And we very quickly see that it doesn't fit. So, it doesn't fit here. Well, I wonder if we can make it fit, or if we just wasted $100. I swear I could have made this thing. It was just cheaper to buy it with price of aluminum. Let me see how much wider it is. Like 5 inches. So thinking about mounting it to the front, which will require some field engineering, but you know, it's going to require some field engineering no matter what. yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna mount it to right here. So let's see how that's gonna look. So we're gonna come in like that. Cheat and use the back. So I happen to have an Evolution cold cutoff saw, and this is going to make short work out of this. Bunch of stuff inside there. Let me get my trash can. Thank you. So we're gonna take this now over here. So whether it mounts on the front or the back, this is the general idea. So it looks like we are still a little bit long, but this is what we want to accomplish. So we need to take another 3/4 inch off this. Yeah, I think we're there. Let me get that 3/4 inch off. You guys don't need to watch that. You've seen it now. And I'll be right back. All right, so I have trimmed a little bit. Let's test fit it again. If ever there was a case of testing something more than once, this is it. So I want to bend it just a little bit to tuck it inside this, and then I think we're good. And that's going to put me on the frame behind here, so I think that'll be okay as well. Judging from the front, it will go in the frame. Now, in theory, these are stainless steel screws. I say in theory because, you know, made in China, you have no idea what the hell they sold. Some of these Chinese manufacturers are pretty good, and most of them would sell their grandmother into prostitution if it would make them an extra 10 cents. You might be going, well, wait a second, you're going to screw stuff in. Why are you putting gloves on? Well, you'll see. Put it there, put it here. I put it. There it is. Now, let's see. So I have some DAP Ultra Clear Flexible All-Proof Waterproof Sealant. Everything for everyone, everywhere, anytime, any place. Which translates into, it is probably a mediocre clear sealant, but it will do the trick because this truck cap gets used for wildlife and pest control. If water gets in, it'll probably be refreshing to whatever's inside. Besides which, it's aluminum. Aluminum corrodes, but it forms aluminum oxide, which is tough. So, I don't think it really fucking matters. So I'm using my trusty dusty paint marker. To outline the landing points. without drawing a box all the way around it. Now, amazing how this works sometimes. The manufacturer says to secure the cross members first, but I don't agree with that, so I'm not doing it. That's probably way more than enough, and I'm probably going to scrape most of this out. I fell off one of these little blue ladders and tore the meniscus in my knee several years back, so I am just a little respectful of ladders now. Now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Truth or consequences? Holes. That's what we're doing in this one. It's two per vertical, but I'm going to count these out and see what they get. Doesn't make any sense, so I'm going to put the other way. I think it makes sense. Just say it's not self-tapping. And let's drill it. there's one. I bought a little platform stage for doing elevated work the other day. Top. It bothers me that that's not square or level. Okay. much shit as I've gone through, I want this centered. So there's enough to put three in the shell and two on top, and that should be more than sufficient. So I'm going to put some sealant on it. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do that afterwards because, yeah, this is the way this is going to roll. And of course, OSHA would say, don't stand on the top step because it can be hazardous. I'm sure somebody will comment in the video that I shouldn't stand on top steps because it could be hazardous, to which I would respond, yes, yes, your mother was hazardous too. Being consistent. Thank you. All right, everything up there looks good. All right, so I think that's sturdy enough to hold ladders. Woohoo. So I'm going to put the holes in the top first because it will make my life easier, and I'm going to set them back a little bit. This will simplify things because access to the center is going to be difficult. So we got a little work to do over here. I don't really give a shit. It'll work. I mean, it would be ideal if it sat inside the little thing, but it isn't gonna do any. It isn't gonna make a difference. At the end of the day, this is a work truck. There we go. Alright, now one thing that needs to be done is to put some adhesive on these, because otherwise they will blow off or vanish on the first time it goes through a car wash. Wipe it off like that. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll put a link in the video comments on where to buy this rack and There are a couple things I need to do. So one of the things I need to do is cut these off. I guess I could let you guys watch that. It's not that big of a deal though. Let me pause the video while I set up for that. Alright, so we're just going to trim these with a Sawzall. Alright folks, thanks for watching.